Let us perform convolution between the given two continuous time signals. X of t is a for 0 to 2 and is 0 otherwise, which implies it is a rectangular function. H of t is given as an exponential function, and for the interval t greater than or equal to 0 and is 0 otherwise. We start with writing down the formula of convolution integral, that is y of t is equal to minus integration minus 2 plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. In the first step, we sketch signals x of tau and h of tau as shown in these plots, followed by sketches of x tau and h tau. We perform a folding operation over h of tau. So here we got a folded exponential signal. Followed by a folding operation, we carry out shifting operation, which implies h of t minus tau as a folded impulse response, which is basically an exponential function, where this h is denoted with a generalized amount of shift t in order to ensure whether we have appropriately selected this variable. We can substitute t as 0 and check if it is same as if it results into a folded impulse response function, that is h of minus tau. After that, we combinedly show x of tau, which is a fixed function, and h of t minus tau, what we are going to shift over x of tau. In the first case, we could see that for t less than 0, both signals don't overlap. Therefore, the output of convolution remains 0. As we start shifting h of t minus tau over x of tau, in the second case, both x of tau and h of t minus tau are partially overlap, for the range of t from 0 to 2, and integration limits will be from 0 to t, which shows an overlap region. Substituting x of tau, which is an amplitude a, and h of t minus tau, which is an exponential function, performing the integration operation and substituting the limits of integration, y of t is given as a by 2 in a bracket 1 minus e raised to minus 2 t. Further, h of t minus tau will go on shifting towards the right direction. As it crosses t equal to 2, there will be complete overlap from 0 to 2. Thus, the output of convolution for this overlap region will be computed as an integration limit from 0 to 2, substituting x of tau and h of t minus tau, solving the integration and substituting the limits of integration, it results into this answer. Finally, we combine the entire output y of t, that is the output of convolution integral, for three different regions, that is for t less than 0, for t between 0 to 2, and for t greater than 2. Followed by the answer of y of t, we can also sketch the output of convolution integral as shown in the figure.